just a poor boy, though my story is seldom told. I squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and jest, still a man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. When I left my home and my family, I was no more than a boy in the company of strangers, in the quiet of the railway station, let him scare. Laying low, seeking out the poor quarters where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know. Lie-la-lie, asking only workmen's wages, I come looking for a job, but I get no offers. Just to come home from the wars on 7th Avenue. I do declare there were times when I was so lonesome I took some comfort there. La 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 la. Then I'm laying out my winter clothes and wishing I was gone, going home, where the New York City winters are bleeding me. A boxer and a fighter by his trade, and he carries the reminders of every glove that laid him down or cut him till he cried out in his anger and his shame. I am leaving, I am leaving, but the fighter still remains.
This is the official opening of our golf tournament, hosted by Jeff and our president Peter. So I hope everybody has a very, very good time and everybody behaves, okay? So enjoy. Jeff is going to give us some rules now. So Jeff, I'll leave it over to you.
Well, welcome. But if anyone is suffering from heat, please do not keep playing.
That's a good reason.
I draw the line.
Ball lost or out of bounds, play from where you think you lost it with a two-stroke penalty. No discussion.
Yep. Now this is Brian. As usual, he is late. Boy, where the hell have you been all this time?
I was the first here.
Where?
And I went to the club that serves better food.
So, in other words, you're suggesting this food's made with you, is that it?
Yeah, that's pretty much spot on.
Good on you. Okay, we're about to start the game. Are you all excited or what?
I am. I'm wondering what the course record is here. That's how confident I am.
You mean for the winner or the Naga? Which is it?
The Naga.
Good, have a good game.
All right, enjoy your game too, Sam.
Now, Neville, I reckon you're the dark horse of this competition, okay?
Very dark, mate. Very
are you feeling up to it or not?
So dark, you can probably not see me. I'm going out to enjoy myself.
In the heat. Right. Now, Peter, you're il presidente. So the success or otherwise really is on your shoulders. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling pretty nervous.
Why?
Because I'm among a lot of non-English speaking people.
Oh, hey, what sort of comment is that? I'll have to cut that out. Anyway, are you looking forward to the game?
Looking forward to it immensely.
All right, good on you. Well, it's only going to be 35 degrees, so we should be right.
We should be, some of us will be drooping, okay. Especially the over 80s.
Okay, have a good game. You're the captain.
Thank you.
You've done an awful lot of work for this. Everything going well?
It is.
Okay, you ready to go?
Yes, go.
Okay, good. All right, here's a group of the Three Stooges about four times round, all ready to head off. It's bloody 34 degrees, it's boiling hot. So is everybody ready to go?
Yeah,
yeah, okay, all right. Well, good luck and just drink plenty of water, okay? Good on you. Okay, have a good game. How are you coping so far?
No, I'm finished. I'm going home.
What?
Yeah, it's too hot for me.
How many cigarettes have you had today?
Well, none in the way up.
Are you kidding me?
No, Peter was in the car with me.
Good. That's lovely. Well, you should be super fit.
No, the heat and the humidity. Before I was stuffed before we started, Sam. Yeah. I'm better now than I was when I started.
All right. Well, still enjoy the day, okay? Not only is he the star chef, but he's also the star performer of the day. Is that correct or not?
No, that's right. Hang on.
Hey.
Don't let them see the smoke.
Oh my God.
Don't let them see the smoke, Sam.
I take it all back. For God's sake, you're killing him. Get him out of there.
You can't control the temperature.
Oh, you've got to keep turning them.
I'll turn them for half an hour. That's what I'm doing.
How are you feeling, Harry?
Yeah,
a pretty hot day.
It's too hot.
Yeah, anyway, you did the right thing.
Oh, I know I did the right thing. I always do the right thing.
Good man. Well, I don't know about that, but in this case, we'll let you on. Good. Say that again so people can hear it.
Samuel, that was the best drive of the day.
Whoa, that's a big statement.
Straight down the middle, beat everybody.
Good on you. Thank you for that. It was a bit of a fluke, but anyway.
I don't think so. I think that shot back,
shot through the ball,
what miracles.
Just with your head. I suppose we have to congratulate, this is our winner for the day, as I understand.
We haven't got a winner yet.
What do you mean we haven't got a winner?
The car's turned in.
Okay, well, you're looking pretty confident, so that's good. All right, you're doing a great job against all odds, Tony.
No, I'm under pressure.
You're under pressure, all right, but you're doing a good job. Tony, how was it?
Are you allowed to use four-letter words?
You can do whatever you like, I'll cut you out.
Oh, fuck. No, it was a great day, great company. The boys, two or three of the boys played really well. I didn't play so well, but, you know, I have to give Brian a run for his money for the Naga. So I'm in there with a chance for the Naga.
Okay, that's very good to hear.
Jeff,
turn around. Okay, stop eating your sausage. So you've had a pretty good day from what I heard. What did you score?
36.
You're so modest. And guess who outdid you with the longest drive? Tell me.
Yeah, I know. I'm not
going to
say it.
No, don't say it. You'll choke on it, I know. Anyway, it was a great round. You did very well. We've already got you. I think I've got you on tape. I'm cutting you right out. But you had a good day as well, right?
I had a terrible day.
Did you? Yeah, I know.
I was given as a responsibility. I'm looking after one of the older members of the...
And you did a great job.
Yeah, I did a great job.
Yeah. At a cost.
Right.
Anyway, we'll take that into account. Well done. Neville, how was your day? Yeah, no, you're close enough, believe me.
I had a very ordinary day.
Ordinary being, give me a score.
Golf line, 25.
25, it's not bad, I wouldn't complain.
I was impressed with at least a few of my
friends.
Mark, our leader here, 36.
Yeah.
I'm glad
I bought 25. Wow, that seems to be the group, yeah.
But I found the course very, very long.
Yeah, good. Yeah, it was hard. And it was a hot day. This is the guy that's over. He's just... Come on, Peter. Tell us your score. Come on.
I had a great day.
Yeah.
All you younger people should be ashamed of yourself. Wang at Octogenaria, which is 217, to finish with 34.
Yeah, I agree. Who sets a bloody... handicaps. It's not fair. You've lost five strokes as a result, okay? Anyway, well done, Peter. Congratulations. Okay, David, your turn. What have you got to say?
That was a splendid day.
Well done. Oh, oh.
Beautiful. Yeah, okay. It's a bit hot, but really nice day, good company. And wind's a bit of a...
And you got beaten by an old guy. Is that it? Is that what you're trying to say? These are my playing partners. Oops. Turn around, that's it. Okay.
Beautiful day out there. I don't know about the company.
Was it the company that made you score so poorly, was it?
Absolutely.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yeah. Ryan and I, we work together. We're both going again here. Naga and I get the
money. I enjoyed every moment of it, same as you could see.
Good. Have a job. How was your day?
I had a lovely first nine, beautiful course, playing well, until lack of fitness and category struck, and the second nine was very bad.
I think he's got everyone had a bit tired. Well, some of us did anyhow, but anyway, it's doing great. Well done. Mark, you look like you're on a holiday to Hawaii. Obviously, you're all refreshed, had a shower. How was your day?
The golf was shocking, the company was fantastic, and it's a great location.
Actually, do you realise that our group was the worst group of the whole bloody lot?
Well, I don't know, because they haven't heard the other scores yet.
I assure you, we were.
We were the worst, were we?
We were the worst. Never mind.
If we break it up tomorrow, we can spread it around amongst the best of them.
Do they have a Naga for a group?
I don't suggest
that. Okay. This is our wine connoisseur. You're in charge of all the wine. I want you to tell me the quality of the wine. Is it worthwhile or not?
There are some very good wines in the collection.
And some very poor ones?
No, I don't think there's any bad ones. There's some I don't know.
Thank God, I got through. Anyway, did you have a good day?
Yeah.
Okay, well done. That's good.
Anyway, here I am. I'm the official video taker, and I've had to put up with a bloody mulch all day. But my golf has gone downhill because I'm worried about taking their video. But overall, it's been a pretty hot for the good day. A long day, I might add. So we're all relaxing and having a good time because we're all sick at the moment.
What's this about the longest drive? Come on.
First time in my life I've got a longest drive. Everybody else stuffed up, so that was the end of that. Anyway, it was a good day, thank you.
And the winner of the nearest to pin is Tony Brotherton. The longest drive.
I only lost three of these today.
Come on, everybody, clap.
Was an absolute. Absolute fluke, won by Sam Zappullo.
Oh, boo! Who said boo?
Better known as the Sicilian Mafia.
As you know, the short course was done over four holes, the 2nd, the 8th, the 10th and the 17th. And with a score of...
One.
Watch this. 12 points. It was won by Peter Penn.
Oh, yay! Hey.
Third prize. With a score of 35 points, but losing on a count back is Tony Brother.
Tony.
Also with a score of 35, but a better score on the back nine was Dave Pogue.
Right on you, Dave. The third prize, believe it or not, Bob Bourne, 36 points.
El Capitan.
El Capitan, Jeff Dobber.
And I would remind you that now is the time to ask everyone what their score is, and if it's greater than yours, give them a nod.
This is our second day of play and we're nearly ready to go. How are you gentlemen?
Ready.
Ready and willing and all excited?
Absolutely.
And Tony, what, you got 35 the first time, now you're going to get 40 I suppose, eh?
That's the number of balls that will probably be in the water, yeah.
Okay, alright, anyway, enjoy your day. Now, Kevin is not feeling the greatest.
No, he's 100%.
He's fine. No, I think it's just if you overindulge. That's what it is.
No, not at all.
Not at all?
It must have been the way I was fed. I was late for the chef de jour was late for the barbecue, so they spiked my sausage.
And not the six beers that you drank, no?
Yeah, might have been that. Never that.
Obviously, this is the first hole. The ninth green's just over here to my left, your right. So you come by here halfway, and the 18th green's across the road in front of the green.
Second game has been finished, everyone is rather sweating and enjoying a beer. So Peter, tell me all about it. How was it?
It was, from a golf point of view, terrible. I started off with two wipes and I finished with a wipe. And in between times I managed to get all the ones and twos and finish with 24.
He's driving. Yeah, that's good. Well, anyway, but you're feeling good. And it's overall a been a success?
I feel that...
Yeah, well, I've got to drive.
I'm very proud of myself.
I was going to have 10 minutes.
Okay, the game is over and everybody's enjoying their drink, okay? So I'm going to go around and see if I can get some comments. It might be very difficult, but I'm going to try. Righto, Harry, go for it.
No, I'm not
going to
say it.
You know? What aren't you going to say? There's a lady behind you, for God's sake.
Oh, sorry. No, it was a lovely day. Terrific. Can we play another 9 holes?
Yes. Right. Yeah. Okay.
You should have said beer. Should have seen the look on Harry's face. I told you, have you heard that Jeff's organised another 18?
Tony, you played very well.
After 9 holes, I was wondering what the course record was.
Kevin, my playing partner, for God's sake, you got anything nice to say?
Sam, you don't even want to know what I want to say.
I'll tell you, you're a pain.
If I wasn't playing with Sam, I wouldn't have wanted to be out there.
That's a compliment on it, isn't it?
It's the only one you're going to get.
Bruce, what have you got to say?
I've got every one of my muscles. 2 dames of golf.
Well, I'll tell you what, you've got muscles, though. I mean, none of us, we all got flab. Well, you got muscles. You're lucky, aren't you? Well done.
I need somebody to carry me out.
Mark, you look pretty sane, actually.
Do I?
Yeah.
I wouldn't have sounded too sane on about the 16th. But it's a great day. Great course. Lousy swing.
Well done. Brian?
Another terrific day. Thoroughly enjoyable.
That's good. Main person, what have you got to say?
Well,
you played pretty well.
I enjoyed the course.
Tell us what you got. What did you score?
33.
33 is pretty bloody good. You're going to be up there somewhere.
I never wiped. That was amazing.
That's good. Well done.
Harry.
David. Stick your head out of here. How was your day today?
It was really good side until I mucked up my knuckle with a dodgy three-wood, which is my problem, on the 14th.
And I scored 3 points off the mark. I was heading for a 40-point. I finished on 34.
Well, that's pretty good. Oh my God, that sounds very good. Tony.
Yes, sir.
Now listen, just... tell us, have we got enough drinks left for tonight or not?
Harry, do you want another?
You've got that much wine. Yes.
Another
two?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, we'll go. We will be starting after this session. A cellar.
An aged,
the aged, the ageless. aged wine cellar. with the left arrow, you'll have to start selling.
Good, okay. Well, it's going to be a happy night. We've had 2 days of great days, really. The golf has been pretty ordinary, but the fun has been good. So I hope everyone's enjoyed themselves, and I look forward to next year. But having said that, we've still got a whole evening of rubbish going on. And I played Kevin with Kevin today, and if he's an example of what rubbish is all about, we're in trouble. So thank you very much. Okay.
Jeff wanted the stones, but I think he's best. I think we'll go the kings. Yeah, I love that wood. Mate, I was walking there twice. I got trains at Waterloo.
The nearest the pit, and that is a magnificent three balls won by Tony Porter. A very fluky long drive was won by Mark Hayes.
Am I allowed to make a speech here? My speech is all I can say is it was the one decent shot out of 36.
Yeah, miles. You had to hit a sprinkler. Okay. 100 metres.
The short course champion, and proving it wasn't a fluke, went to Mr. Peter Pemberton.
Again! Yay!
Okay, then we had the championship itself. The third place with 30 points was Mr. Tony Dwyer.
What again?
You're on a drum.
Taking this one step at a time. Fair enough. Okay. Neville Cousins had 33 and he came second today.
Hey. Well done, Neville! Hey.
Well
done, Neville.
Two very balls solid and a bottle of wine.
Thank you.
A magnificent shot.
That's right.
And first place today.
With 34 points,
Mr. Dave Buck.
Like a Scottish invasion.
He shed himself.
Prepared, obviously. And English has always been my second language. I've always struggled with English, so I'm not sure if you understand that. But just thanks to everybody for. I couldn't think of a better bunch to come away with. yeah, it's okay, but I'm only saying that. Thanks to Jeff and Tony for doing the organisation. Well done, boys. And I've just thoroughly enjoyed it.
I just would like to thank you all for coming and being such a cooperative group. You all get on really well together, and it's been a great couple of days. So hopefully we can do it again. But if any of you don't want to do it again, let us know, and we'll either think of something else or give it a miss. But there's many people who own equipment in Auburn.
I thought you were accused of not speaking English. But I think we've had a lot of great efforts, not only in the winners, but in people playing under injury, etc. We've had long drives, we've had short putts, and we've had a great time. And if I look at it all round, I could nominate any one of you, actually. But one has to be nominated. And I think we've had a wonderful tournament, well organised, everything taken care of. So the only person that I would like to nominate this occasion is the one person who has done all this, Jeff Dober.
Well done. Well done.
Well deserved. Good course champion. Refer to my notes just in case I make a mistake. With a score of 21 points for the 8 holes that we had this thing going in. And it was for the ball ring at the Black Ball plus hole 16, so the most difficult holes on the course, par threes on the course, and the winner is Peter Pennant.
Of course. Oh, hey, well done, Peter.
Give one
and
the other. What's going on?
Well done, Peter.
Shots will always be welcome, and if you can get a couple of lessons, let me know. My legal advisor is Neville. He will give you the contract.
Solicited.
Well done, Peter.
We changed Harry's score to 15 on the first round, right? And he sprung a 28 on the second round, and he won the Naga by a point from Brian. So Harry,
well done, Harry. Well done, Harry.
You're the Naga champion. Well done.
Well done, Harry.
And well deserved.
We'd like to tell Tony how.
Harry.
And a runner-up with 65 points. The runner-up was someone called Jeff Dunn.
Ah, well done.
Hey, wow. Good work.
Good work.
Well, and we have a new champion, and Tony played very well as the reigning champion. I'm not sure exactly the points he got, but it was quite high. And Aaron's been unlucky with perhaps 10 of his holes. And as a result, he's no longer the champion. Champion with 69 snowball points is Dave.
Yay! Well done, Dave.
Shots.
You've already worked your speech out.
The wine and the truck.
Yeah, well, I'd just like to reiterate, thanks to organised and Tony as well. It's a good support. Fantastic. No. And for the camera work, I'd like to nominate Sam.
Thank you. You're welcome.
But thanks. It's been a great couple of days. I've loved every minute. Great crowd to come over here. Great roommate as well, Bruce. And Bruce helped out with the snacks and everything. I can't really say much more.
Hugely good snorer.
Well done. But I just want to thank Jeff particularly for organising all this. I think it's been pretty fantastic. And thank you for your fellowship. And I'm only here because I wanted to be able to film for a little while. Is that okay with you?
Yeah.
Thank you for the weekend of a couple of days. It's been wonderful. Have a safe trip.
Sergio Leone was one of my favourite film
directors. Lily Riaz, my cousin.
I think you're welcome to this.